In this video, you'll see how to use AWS Service Catalog Service Actions with Amazon Relational Database Service, or Amazon RDS, products. With Service Actions, you can allow users to perform common operational tasks on Amazon RDS products, define the service actions users can take, and associate those actions with specific products. Let's start in the role of an end user who has been granted permissions in the AWS Service Catalog. The user can select from a catalog of different products to provision as needed, including several RDS products. For the purposes of this example, let's quickly go through the process of launching a MySQL database on AWS. First, provide a name for the provisioned product. Specify the parameters needed to launch the database. Provide a master username and password for the database. Proceed through the rest of the screens, review the settings, and launch the database. Within minutes, the database will be available for use on AWS. Administrators can allow users to perform service actions on provisioned databases. This reduces management overhead and allows users to perform common tasks without seeking assistance. In this case, end users are permitted to create an RDS snapshot of the database. They can simply click Run Action to perform that task. Let's navigate to RDS to confirm that this action has been performed successfully. The manual snapshot has been created as expected. Now, let's switch to the perspective of an AWS admin to see how to add custom actions to products and make them available to end users. Navigate to Service Catalog. Select Service Actions. Here you can see any service actions you have already associated with products. Let's create a new action. You can choose from a list of predefined Systems Manager, or SSM, documents that can be used as custom actions, or you can create your own. Let's filter this list to show only SSM documents for RDS products. Select the Reboot RDS Instance document. Review the settings and create the action. Next, let's associate this action with a specific product. Select an available product version and then associate the action. Returning to the end user's perspective, we can now see the new action in our list of options. Let's use it to reboot our database. Once again, let's ensure the action was carried out. As you can see, the database is now in the rebooting state. You've just seen how to use AWS Service Catalog Service Actions with Amazon RDS products. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.